Hello and welcome to Free Linux Tutorial. My name is Usman Ahmad and in this session we're going to learn how to install Grafana on Linux. I have created this guide here which I will share the link with you and you can follow this as well as it contains some basic information about Grafana and then follow the step how to install Grafana and so on. So let's get it started. So what is Grafana? So in very short, it is basically a monitoring tool which help you to visualize data. It is totally free, which means it is open source and also cross-platform supported. This means that you can install Grafana on Windows, on Linux, on Mac, even on Raspberry Pi and so on. You can even use Grafana on Docker and Kubernetes as well. It does not require to upload your data which you want to visualize in its database. All it needs that if you have an endpoint, then Grafana only need to connect to that data source, which is its endpoint, and it will start displaying the data. It is very widely used in production and in complex environment where, for example, monitoring Kubernetes or cloud and doing the observability. You can also create very nice and clean dashboard in Grafana and easily share as your requirement. And last but not least, Grafana provide very powerful features such as transforming your data or filtering out the information you needed, and also contains some other modules, for example, alerting, tracing, metrics, etc. So what are the different editions of Grafana? This always confuses a new user that which Grafana they should use. So Grafana is actually available in three editions. The Grafana OSS we just talked about is the free one, Grafana Enterprise is the paid one, and Grafana Cloud comes in both options, free and paid. The free version have some limitation while the paid version have all the features of Grafana Enterprise but also some cloud specific as well. However, it is not possible to cover all the references, so here is the link to the metrics table where you can see what are the features available in each edition and compare based on your need, and you can use whatever fits for your requirement. So let's start with the installation part. So first is the system requirements. Grafana is actually very lightweight, so it does not need heavy resources. All you need is around 256 MB of RAM and one CPU core. Please keep in mind that if in case you're using some features, for example, alerting or image rendering, or maybe taking a lot of monitoring a lot of logs, taking them from a data source, and it is very heavy, then you might to increase the hardware requirement, for example, more memory, more CPU, and so on. Database requirements. By default, Grafana ships with SQLite. This is the default database. That means that we do not have to install or configure this. It comes in within the package. So this is a good for us. And the other options available is MySQLite. Oh, pardon me, MySQL and Postgres. Which you can use as a database instead of SQLite. We will take a look into it later as we progress through in the next sessions. For now, we will also use SQLite. Browser requirements. So Grafana supports the latest and stable version of the following browser, which is Chrome, Firefox, Safari, and Edge. Very common these days. One important point to note here is that the JavaScript must be enabled on your browser. Otherwise, when you're trying to use Grafana or maybe view some visualization, it will not work as expected and may run into problems. Now comes the installation part. So for this session, I'm using a RPM-based CentOS distro, and the command is actually dnf update, or if dnf is not available, can also use yum update. And for those who are using Debian or maybe Ubuntu, can use apt-get update. So let's try this. Let me just maximize the screen. Yeah, looks good. Nice, my system is up to date. Now we have to choose the correct version of Grafana release. So Grafana is actually available in two types of releases. The first one is stable, OSS stable, and the other is nightly build. So what does it mean? So I have a link here. So basically this is the link. And here we can see that this is the page where we can download Grafana. However, we can see, okay, this is the version which we can select and the edition. And we are focused right now on the OSS, the free one. And this is the stable release. But here it gives an option to use the nightly builds. Nightly builds means that these are not the stable one. They are taken from the dev branch and maybe a bit unstable. However, they might be useful if you want to test out the next version of Grafana. Maybe a feature is available and want to see how it works. So to get the nightly build, just click here. And now you see the version is now changed and it shows at the end pre, which means it's not the stable one. We will go back to the release and use the OSS stable one, which is the default. So we don't need to worry about, but I wanted to mention this here as it could be useful for those who want to use the different version of Grafana. Now we have to install the official repository. And the first step is to getting the GPG key. To do that, we need to use the wget command and paste this URL. Perfect. Now we just import it using the rpm command. This looks good. Now we have to create a repository in our machine to download the package. To do that, we have to create a file and we name it, for example, grafana.repo. You can name it maybe only my custom grafana.repo, it doesn't matter. And but the location should be etc/yum.repos.t. To do that, I first create this file. And now I need to copy paste all this content. So what I can do is that I can use any editor. For example, I like to use Vim or VI. So I use the same path, but change it here. And you can use anyone you want, doesn't matter. And insert, copy paste it, save. Now, there's a small thing that you can also use Vim editor if you still don't know. Vim is also useful as it gives a color coded output. And I want to show you something here is that here I added this line extra. So it could be possible that when we download the Grafana package, it might give us a beta option as a default to download. To avoid any beta installation, just put this line beta is equals to wildcard beta. And that way we will have no beta package available for download. We can test this out, obviously. So now we come to the part we have to download and install Grafana. So let's do that. Not asking me for us to install a key. GPG key, yeah, yes. And a list of packages. And before we hit yes, to continue, we still check, okay, the architecture is x86-64, this is the version, it's not beta, so it means this is a stable release, and it's coming from our Grafana repository. Perfect. So we press Y, and now wait for the installation to get completed. Now the next step is to start configuring the service. And to do that, we have to first start the Grafana server. as by default, when we install Grafana, it is not automatically get started. We have to do this manually, and this is the command. So we copy paste it. So this is a system command, systemctl start grafana-server, and let's press enter. It's taking some time. Okay, it works. Now, it might be a case that this command does not work on your side. And what you can do is that you can use this command, systemctl daemon reload. You may use it, for example, with sudo or with admin privileges, and then just retry this command again, and then it should work. In our case, it works. But to confirm it, we need to check the status. So this is the command to check the status. Similar command, what we are replacing is start with status. So let's copy this. And this is what we need to see. So we see that it says it is active and running. And then it gives us some details about the logs, which is good. But we are more interested right now to see that that is now active and running. This is what exactly explained here as well. And now if we want to make Grafana to be start up automatically when next time we restart our machine, simply enable this service on startup by this command. And now we created a symlink, and this will start automatically whenever the next time the system reboots. Now we have to access Grafana, and to do that we need to type in the web browser the IP and the port. The default port is 3000. So let's check the IP of our machine. So it's IPA, and the IP is this one. I copy it. It's 3000. And I see the login page. In your case, it might be that you have to use localhost or find the IP using the IPA command, which I did here, the IPA command. Perfect. Now to log into Grafana, we have to use admin for both username and password. So admin and admin. Now what it does is that it is asking for a new password. It's up to you. You can create a new password and confirm it. But for now, I will just skip it. And now we are able to log into Grafana UI, and this means everything works fine. And this is really good. Just a small note here that the admin command is basically means that you are logging in Grafana as a super admin user and you have all the privileges. There are no restrictions in this account. So be careful whatever you do. If you delete something, then it will be deleted permanently. Troubleshooting. So although in our case, everything works as expected, but there might be some problem in your case that you need to troubleshoot. So for example, if you cannot access the URL where Grafana is running, for example, if you are running on your local host or with the IP and you still cannot access via web browser, then you can use the curl command. And to use the curl command, basically curl and then type the IP address of your machine. And if you're running it locally, then just localhost port 3000. So what I will do, I do the same. I type the curl command, then I paste this IP and then port 3000. And what it shows me is that it found the endpoint. So it says found. So this means that it is accessible. This is good. And in case if this does not help, or there might be some other issues that if you log in Grafana and then you get some strange error here, or it just stuck or anything, then you can use the log file to check what is the problem. For that, what you can do is that you go to the cd var log Grafana, This is the default path for the Grafana log files in Linux. And if I do a ls command, I can see the Grafana log. And if I do a less grafana.log, I can see the whole log file here. And press page up or page down key on your keyboard, and you can see all the details, whatever happening in the background. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. I hope you really like this session and it is really helpful and informative for you, especially for those who are new to Grafana and also those who are using Grafana but maybe have issues in troubleshooting or things like that. We will keep continuing these sessions about Grafana, and thank you everyone for your time, and I will see you all in the next video. Thank you, take care, and goodbye.